Hi friends, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. Today we will learn program for longest common subsequence. Given two sequences, we have to find the length of longest subsequence present in both of them. So what is a subsequence? A subsequence is a sequence that appears in the same relative order but not necessarily contiguous. For example, if given two sequences are these, then some of the common possible subsequences are these. And the longest common subsequence is A, B, D, F, G. Let us take an example. Consider the input strings L1 with length M and L2 with length N such that L1 is A, G, G, T, A, B and L2 is G, X, T, X, A, Y, B. There can be two cases. The last characters match or the last characters do not match. If the last characters match, increment the length of LCS by 1 and process L1 of M-1 and L2 of N-1. If the last characters do not match, find the maximum of L1 M-1 L2 N and L1 M L2 N-1. Consider the partial recursion tree drawn here for LCS of the strings AXYT and AYZX. Notice that LCS of AXY and AYZ is being solved twice. So, if we draw the complete recursion tree, then we can see that there are many subproblems which can be solved again and again. We know that recomputation of same subproblems can be avoided by using dynamic programming. Let us see how we can achieve that. LCS is a table that stores the length of longest common subsequence for the given pair of strings. Let us build LCS of M+1, N+1 in bottom-up manner and see what happens. The character phi represents an empty subsequence of length 0. So, we initialize the first row and first column with 0 value. Now we move to the next row and compare G with the characters in the string AGGTAB. Since A does not match with G, we pick the maximum of the values stored in the left cell and the top cell. Since G matches with G, we pick the diagonal cell value and increment it by 1. So, length of LCS becomes 0 plus 1, that is 1. Again, G matches G, so length of LCS becomes LCS of diagonal cell plus 1, that is 0 plus 1 is 1. G does not match T, so maximum of left and top cell is 1. Length of LCS becomes 1. Similarly here, 1 is the length of LCS. And here also, we will fill 1 for same reason. Now we move to the next row. X does not match A. So, maximum of left and top cell is 0. Length of LCS becomes 0. Here, X does not match G. So, length of LCS becomes maximum of top and left cell, that is 1. Since X does not match any character of the string AGGTAB, we fill 1 in the remaining cells. Now, we move to the next row. T does not match A. So, length of LCS is maximum of top and left cell, that is 0. T does not match G. So, length of LCS is maximum of top and left cell, that is 1. T does not match G. So, length of LCS is maximum of top and left cell, that is 1. Here, T matches T. So, length of LCS becomes LCS value at diagonal cell plus 1, that is 1 plus 1 is 2. We can fill the rest of the table following the same logic. In case of match, LCS of I and J is equal to LCS of I minus 1, J minus 1, which is the diagonal cell plus 1. In case of mismatch, LCS of I, j is equal to maximum of LCS of I minus 1, j, which is left cell, and LCS of I, j minus 1, which is top cell. This is the final LCS table. Here, LCS of MN is equal to 4, which gives us the length of the longest common subsequence. Let us see how we can obtain the longest common subsequence using this table. We start from the bottom right corner. If we see that the stored value is not the maximum of top and left cell, it means the current character is a part of the longest common subsequence. So we pick the character B and move diagonally up. Since 3 came from top cell, we move up. Since 3 is not the maximum of top and left cell, we pick the character A and move diagonally up. Since 2 came from top cell, we move up again. Since 2 is not the maximum of top and left cell, we pick T and move diagonally up. Here, 1 is the maximum of top cell and left cell, but this time both the top cell and left cell have the same value, so we can move in either direction. Let's move up. 1 came from left cell, we move left. 1 is not the maximum of left and top cell, we pick character G and move diagonally up. Since the stored value is 0, we stop. So, GTAB is the longest common subsequence. Let us look at the code now. LCS is a function that takes 4 parameters. X is a pointer that points to the first sequence of length M. Y is a pointer that points to the second sequence of length N. Following steps, build L of M plus 1, N plus 1 in bottom-up fashion. If either I is 0 or J is 0, LCS value becomes 0. Else, we fill the table according to the two cases. In case the last letters match, L of I, J becomes L of I minus 1, J minus 1 plus 1. Else, we pick the maximum of L of I minus 1, J and L of I, J minus 1. At last, we return L of M, N, which is the final value of the length of subsequence. Thanks for watching. For any queries or doubts, please comment below.